And as these folks come to be baptized, they're going to just give you a word of testimony and tell you what the Lord has done for them. And I want you to just rejoice with them because the Lord has done great things in their lives. And if you've walked into this place, I'm sure you have, because you probably heard something was going on. Well, it is. And we're all just still in shock because it's amazing how you get used to church without God. And then when he shows up, you don't know how to act. Isn't it great? Woo! How many of you are here tonight for the very first time? First time ever. God bless you. Let me ask this question. How many here are here for this week? This, like, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday was your first service. This is your first week of being here. God bless you. Amen. Well, tonight, when you walk into this building, if you need Jesus in your heart, you're going to know him before you leave. He's going to set you free, and he's going to change you into a person you didn't think you could be. Hallelujah. Because there is a hope in Jesus. There is a hope. Come on, sing. Everybody sing with me. There is a hope in Jesus. There is a hope. Just one more time. Everybody, lift up your voice. Yes, there is a hope in Jesus. There is a hope. There's a hope in him. Yes, there is. There is a hope in Jesus. There is a hope. There is a hope in him. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated. I thought I'd lost my list again. Glory. Tonight, helping us with baptism. I love this. Whew. Is Pastor Perry Dalton from Pine Forest United Methodist Church. And Brother Johnny Stump of Brownsville, we have 21 people coming tonight to be baptized. I want you to rejoice. Amen.
Glory.
My name is Tina Lewis.
I'm Nancy Rosensteel, and I accepted Christ as my Savior when I was a child, and I gave my life to him thoroughly when I was a teenager. But I was raised in a denomination that not only didn't believe in baptism, but they didn't even believe in the different powers of the Holy Spirit. It is truly merciful of the Lord that I'm here tonight to be baptized, because it's taken a lot to get here. And I'm grateful that he's been very gentle with me in my process of breaking the religious bindings that have been in my life. And I'm just grateful tonight that old has passed away and the new is becoming.
I'm Rebecca Passmore, and we came from South Carolina to this revival, and it's been a real blessing. And I just love the Lord with all my heart, and I just want to thank you for everything he's done for me. My name is Belinda, and I want to thank the Lord for what he's done for me. I've lost a lot of battles in my life, but I want to give God the glory, and I want to give Satan a black eye and tell him that I'm going to win the last battle.
My name's Carmen Alexander, and my husband and I were saved on January 28th here, and we've been coming ever since. I was baptized when I was a little girl, but I've been away from the Lord for a long time now. But the best way I can describe it is the way Allison said. He's always had a place in my heart, but he's not had a place in my life until now. And he doesn't give up on you, and I just want to thank him for not giving up on me.
Robin Sweat, and I want to thank God for just filling me with his joy and peace, and thank you,
Hi, my name is Charity, and I love Jesus so much, and I just want to be the best Christian I can be. Yeah.
My name is Ariel Short, and I just love God with all my heart.
Amen.
My name is Brandy, and I just want to say that God doesn't care where you've been or what you've done. He will always take you back. Yes. And if you're out there tonight and you're backslidden, you need to come back to Jesus, because he's longing to fellowship with you and to spend time with you. When I was out in the world, Jesus was watching me, and he was just waiting for me to come back. And there's nothing that you've done that he won't forgive you of. And Mom, I love you. I put my mom through so much. She's in the choir right here, and she's so beautiful. I love you, Mom. You bless me. You bless me. I'm sorry for everything I did.
Thank you, Lord.
My name is Mary Jo. I gave my Lord to the Christ at the age of 12. Actually, I gave my life to the Lord at the age of 12. It's time to reaffirm my faith, reaffirm my dedication, and have a rebirth in the Lord.
Thank you. I just want to be more obedient to what the Lord's called me to do. I just feel like He wants me to do this for more change in my life.
First thing I want to say is hallelujah, Lord. My name is Mary Dodd, and I would like to give my testimony, but if I get started, it's going to take way too long. You know, I spent most of my life just asking God to give me this and give me that, and never enough time for thanking Him. But I'm telling you what, He has blessed me so much in the last few days that I hadn't had time to ask for nothing. All I've been doing is, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus. He's done so much in our family. My nephew's going to follow me. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
My name's Carl Apley. In January, I was in an accident, almost lost my life. Thank God he spared me so I could be here today.
Yeah.
I'm a single father, I got two children. I didn't know what I was gonna do for a job to support my children. I didn't have a vehicle, I'm still not working. But the Lord, I believe He's calling me to come into the ministry and preach for Him. Since then, since I've gotten saved, 2 weeks tomorrow, I've gotten a very close friend of mine. I brought her to Jesus. I brought the mother of one of my children. She came to church with me last night. She got saved. I just hope the Lord I'm on fire, and I just hope that He keeps me that way, and that I can just, something comes out of me. He's brought me from drugs, alcohol.
Thank you, Lord.
I've been in gangs. I would ask you, if you don't have the Lord in your heart, don't wait, for there might not be a tomorrow. Do it today. Do it today. Thank you, Jesus.
First of all, I want to thank Jesus that I'm here. And second, I want to thank my daughter, Debbie. Debbie, will you stand up? Stand up, Debbie. Debbie invited me to come to church with her. And I thank you, and I love you for it. Huh? I want to thank Brother Steve Hill for giving such an awesome altar call that brought me to the altar on my knees. Thank you, Brother Steve. Brother John Kilpatrick, I couldn't ask for a better pastor of a church. I thank you. I love you, sir. In June, about a week before Brother Steve came here, I come on a Sunday morning service. That night, I had a dream. that people were going to be pushing and shoving to get in the doors. Look at it. And I heard it's going to get a lot better than that. Thank you, Jesus.
My name is Chris Lewis, and I just want to thank the Lord for my salvation. And my wonderful family up there. I just thank you and I praise you, Lord Jesus, for my family. Thank you. Yes.
My name is Mark Alexander. I've been baptized before when I was young, but the world dragged me away. And every time I would get in a situation where I shouldn't be there, I would always hear this voice that told me, look around. And I would look around and the voice would tell me, you don't belong here. These people are not like you. So I finally came to this church. My wife had been here before and she had asked me to come. So I came with my wife and got here that morning and thought I could just sit back there in a third pew and nothing would affect me. I brought my shield with me and everything. So I sat back there and Linda began to worship, and I was a drummer all through middle school and high school, so he started worshiping, and I thought, yeah, you know, I really like this, you know, I could get into this. So it wasn't long I heard that voice, and it said, look around you. And I did. And it said, you belong here. So I'm obeying the Lord now. I know that was his voice all those years. He stayed with me all through my life. No matter what I did, how I did it, he was always there telling me that I did not belong in those places. And the Lord is a patient Lord. He's a wonderful Lord. And I just want to thank him for never leaving me. My wife and I will be members here at the end of this month. And I'm just saying, Lord, just do with me what you will. Thank you, Lord.
I'm going to attempt to try and share the mercy seat with you. You're probably going to see a grown man cry. I can't help it. The Lord touched my life 18 years ago next month. I was an alcoholic, a drug addict, pill popper, whoremonger, you name it. I was chief. I got saved in a ladies' luncheon, and my wife left a year later. That was one of the hardest things for me to deal with. You know, you're trying to live right, and the person you think's going to be there is no longer there. But there's someone who will always be there, and Jesus came on the scene. But after about 13 years of living alone, it got to me. I wound up and caught up in the things that I thought I'd never get up caught up in fornication, adultery. I became a prodigal son. My son came to live with me, and the only reason I didn't go back into the world was fighting to try and stay in church so my son wouldn't be like me and wouldn't wind up like I did. And it was tough. It's tough raising a child if you're a single parent by yourself. And here, about 8 or 9 months ago, I said, God, my heart ain't right. It's rotten clean through the core. And he revealed to me that my attitude stunk all the way to heaven. And I said, God, change my heart. I don't like what I've become. And I was crying out for righteousness, sanctification, purity, and to be what I should have been. With all my heart, I was crying. I cried bucket loads of tears, people. And I heard about this revival, and I started coming. I said, God, I need a new heart. Created me a right heart. Renew my spirit, because it ain't right. And through Brother Steve and this revival, God touched my heart. He's totally given me a new heart. He's turned my life around. My son graduates in May. I've spent most of the last 18 years of my life getting him graduated. I'm spending the rest of my life, regardless of what it is, serving Jesus, not the secular world. I don't care if he wants me to preach in Bangladesh, Egypt, Africa, just to share anywhere in the world, I'm ready to go. Just do with me what you want to do, Lord, I'm yours.
I guess the only thing I really got to say is, hallelujah!
question. First of all, I'd like to thank all the people that have really been a blessing to my life. Joey Lewis and all the other guys, all my family, y'all have all been great. Everybody in the youth group, I love you. I love you, Pastor Kilpatrick and Brother Steve. I love you guys. Y'all doing a really great job. And especially most of all, Brother Richard, he's... I've been thinking about what I'm going to say, and I just want to say one thing. I've been running for a while, but it's running from the wrong person. I've been running from the devil. I've been scared of the devil for a long time, and I want to tell the devil right now that I ain't scared of him no more. Jesus Christ has given me authority over the devil, and through Jesus Christ, we will stomp on his feet. He can bruise our heels, but we'll smash his head. In the name of Jesus Christ, watch out, devil, because here I come.
My name is Don Rosensteel, and that was my wife that was in the front of the line before. Since we've been coming here for 9 months, the Lord has been working in my life, but I've been having trouble with obedience. Last Friday night, as I was resting in the aisle over here, I had this message that said, "What am I supposed to do now?" And it flashed this pool. Brilliant in colors. So here I am. And you might say, so what? Except I grew up in a mainline denomination that kind of sprinkled babies for baptism. So here I am, really. A word for those folks who haven't come to the Lord. Whether you know it or not, you're with the devil, because that's where you were born. And if you haven't gotten a passport out of there, and haven't got your walking papers out of there, you need to be thinking about that, because later, Brother Steve's going to tell you how to do that. And he's going to give you the route to get out of there and join the family of God. And if you do that, then you'll be able to join me and the saints and the angels saying, "Yes, Lord, I will ride with you." Amen. Hallelujah.